So this was 2 years ago in Mumbai. I attended the Urban Lens Film Festival at Godrej India Culture Lab in Vikhroli. And I've been attending events quite frequently there. So it was pretty curious. I was very intrigued to know what this film festival was about. The fact that it had the word urban in it made me even more excited to know what kind of film festival this is. And it was during this film festival that I got to understand about the fellowship, because once the film festival got over, the Media Lab team sort of talked about the fellowship and urged a call for applications. So because of that, I went back and I checked the IIHS website and the UFP fellowship program, and that's how I got to know about the fellowship. 2 years ago, I was doing my master's in politics, and I had taken two courses in urban politics and urban governance. Towards the end of my master's, I kind of knew what I wanted to do further as far as academia is concerned, but I didn't know where to go. That was the time where I got to know about the fellowship. I went online, I checked the website, and I found out to be a perfect fit for me in terms of my academic knowledge, because I wanted to specialize in the urban, whether it's the politics, whether it's the governance, whether it's the practice, or different perspectives that the urban allows you or gives you as part of understanding, learning, and also working in the field. So taking from that, it was very a perfect timing for me, so to say, because during that time I was also working with local authorities, with councillors in Bombay for another short program. And coming from that background, it was interesting to find courses and electives that talked about the urban, that addressed issues of urbanization and climate change, things that I'm passionate about, not only learning but also working towards in my community back in Bombay. So far, my experience has been really great. Ups and downs because of the rigorousness of the course. Not quite something that I'd expected coming from a conventional academic background back in Bombay. But most of my expectations were really met when I came here, right from the start, when we had the orientation. We were made aware of what's going to happen throughout the weeks in the different terms that were part of this fellowship, that are part of this fellowship. And it was interesting to understand the commons, the electives, and then proceed towards practica where we engaged in the field. One of the most important core courses that remained back with me was identity. It matched my interests as to what I want to reflect on myself when I interact with people, and also understanding how that plays with different institutions, stakeholders, and the society at large. So identity in terms of caste, in terms of class, in terms of gender, how the intersection of caste, class, gender interplays with society, and how policy needs to be informed to address these issues. So that very much remained with me during the first half of the fellowship. I now try to use these themes to sort of in my further studies in the fellowship. So whether it's governance or whether it is understanding cities, how cities are formed, how sustainable they should be, or what is the governance mechanism? How do you create a structure that would address all of these issues and translate into a policy mechanism that would be beneficial for a lot of people? Is something that I took back the most. Another thing that was most interesting for me was that planning was a subject that I had not had any knowledge of. Since I don't come from an architectural design or a planning background, this was very new for me to understand how planning norms are set, what is the master plan about, and several technical terms of the master plan that I now through this fellowship have sort of gained not only an academic but a practical knowledge of how they work, how they are tweaked, what is the politics of planning in that sense, and in a larger sense, how planning influences how cities are made, how cities are produced and reproduced, and how people within cities, outside cities are influenced, and what is the role sort of the influence and the communication and just the movement of space. Just coming out of my master's, I had the pressure of being in a box to understand how academia functions. But ever since I came and I was part of the fellowship, it has truly changed me within internally as to how I understand how the academia functions. The fact that IIHS has created a space of comfort, the fact that your faculty treats you equally, even though it's an educational a workspace. The fact that you're on the same level field with your project lead, with your faculty, and they treat you as one of your own in this space. So that is something that really changed my understanding of academia and my understanding of practice itself. I took few courses on research methodology, on framing narrative to argument, and also on understanding how research work is done. And through practica, through a very immersive experience, I understood that it's not necessarily that you need to follow the conventional methods of academic and research writing. You need to go to the field first, get an immersive experience, understand what it speaks to you and what it speaks of itself, in order to then understand what you want to write, rather than going reading 10 books and then using that to sort of, enforce it on a particular place to create a certain kind of research work. So that has been really, personally concerned, I've really changed in that way. I've had a really good time with my batch. They all come from different backgrounds. They all come from different places, and you get to learn. And I've got a lot to learn from them. I've learned a lot during the fellowship, whether it was only of making friends and being with them, or networking, or understanding from where they come from, or it was going to the exposure visit. So I went to an exposure visit in Chennai towards the mid holidays. And it was a really great experience to blend with my fellow mates and understand their perspective of the city, which was very interdisciplinary. So I have friends who are coming from architectural backgrounds, from design backgrounds, from geography, also from humanities, from engineering, from science and technology. So to understand their perspective is something that adds richness to my understanding of how I should look at cities, how I should look at people, how I should look at processes that are occurring in and around me. The fact that IIHS gives you a space of dissent, having a different opinion and being allowed to speak that opinion, to talk about it, and also negotiate, discuss about it, is a very healthy thing that I find most memorable as part of this fellowship. Towards the latter half of the fellowship, I'm also working on a project on urban health. And I'm using all of these so-called lenses to understand how people in a certain area in KG Halli are experiencing health difficulties, especially non-communicable diseases like diabetes and blood pressure. So my focus on this particular project is understanding the care-seeking behavior of people. How do they know that they are ill, and what do they do after that? Whether they self-diagnose or they go to a public practitioner, and also the suffering aspect of it. How do you gauge an understanding of how people suffer during an illness, or how people suffer if they know of somebody in their family who is having a particular illness? It gave me an understanding as to the different stakeholders that exist and the possibilities that one could work with in the urban. So whether it's consultancy, whether it's an NGO, whether it's a think tank, whether it's a policy institution, whether it's a government official, or even if it's a research work. So it gave me a new area to think of, not only for the internship within IIHS, but also later on in my career. I got selected for one of the projects that IIHS is working on, which is the TURN project, the Tacit Urban Research Network. And one of the groups within IIHS is working in Delhi. So the project that I'll be, the internship that I'll be working on will basically try to gauge the understanding of masculinity, gender, and their experiences of people living in Govindpuri slum. How do they locate themselves in a peripheral area if you look at it from the context of the city? I would really and highly encourage people who are watching this video to apply for the fellowship, more so to the master's program in urban practice and the PhD program that will be be operational in a few years from now. This institute has given me the place and the space of where I want to do, where I want to go and what I want to do. And if any one of you has an interest in the urban, whether it's the politics, the governance, the planning, the economy, whether it's gender, whether it's human rights, or whether it's any issue that you want to work on theoretically, empirically, I believe it is a very good space to engage, to learn, to unlearn, and to relearn back again, so that you contribute to the city in a way, or you contribute to what you want to do in future and to contribute in your career. So I would encourage all of you who are seeing this video to apply for the fellowship.